Jesus came to reveal the Father. He came to reveal that which was perfectly good, the goodness of God. And I just like to put it this way. Jesus Christ is perfect theology. Whatever you think you know about God that you can't find in the person of Jesus, you have reason to question what you think you know. Jesus reveals the Father. Everywhere we turn in the New Testament, we see Jesus touching somebody with love, touching them with power, touching them in a way that changes them forever. Why? Because that's the goodness of God. And you and I have been given this great privilege and an assignment, a commission to demonstrate the goodness of God in the same way Jesus did. And if I try, let's say I pray for someone and they don't get healed, that doesn't change my assignment. My assignment is still to heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out devils, cleanse lepers. That's the assignment. And so what we do is I boil it down to this. As I get alone with God, I cry out for breakthrough. I get in public, I take risk. I look for people with problems. And I pray. I pray my best prayer. If they're healed, if they're delivered, we give God the glory. If they're not, I take responsibility, go back into the prayer closet and cry out to the Lord. It's really the way of life. It's that my assignment doesn't change because of what I think my gifts are. The assignment is the same, to reveal the goodness of God. He who is perfect theology, he who reveals the heart of the Father wonderfully. This is the privilege that we have, is to reveal this same Father, the one who gives that sense of identity, that sense of purpose. He unveils the whole issue of destiny for every believer, every person. So I want to encourage you in this week. Embrace the privilege to let people know who the Father is, not just with words, but with actions, with the way we do life. Let's reveal a Father who is perfectly, perfectly good.